Welcome to the unit overview video for Math 1, Unit 2, Linear and Exponential Functions. This unit provides an in-depth comparison of the key features of linear and exponential functions. We will also use linear and exponential functions to model real-world scenarios. Stan Gutter once said, "The essence of mathematics is not to make simple things complicated, but to make complicated things simple." This idea of making complicated things simple can be achieved through the use of multiple representations. It is not only about breaking something down in a way that you can understand, but also in a way that allows you to communicate your understanding to others. Using a wide variety of representations, such as tables, graphs, explicit equations, and recursive formulas, allows us to communicate mathematical understanding of complex real-world problems in a universal language. This unit will extend the work of arithmetic and geometric sequences of the previous unit to linear and exponential functions. In the previous unit, the sequences were made up of discrete values, but in this unit, we will also look at functions with continuous values. One of the big ideas of this unit includes examining rates of change of linear and exponential relationships. We will examine these two functions using multiple representations such as tables, graphs, and equations. Desmos, an online graphing application, and your graphing calculator will be important tools to learn how to use. You should be familiar with the rules of exponents from previous math courses. The unit begins with a refresher of those rules, in particular, looking at the why behind them. Why do exponent rules work? As well as, how can I rewrite exponential expressions using the rules of exponents? If you understand the why behind the exponent rules, then answering the second question becomes much easier. The focus of this unit is comparing linear and exponential functions. Instead of learning about them separately, the lessons introduce both functions side by side by extending your understanding of arithmetic and geometric sequences. While sequences are a list of numbers, functions are derived from situations in which we are looking at the relationship between two quantities. Here is an example of a linear function written in slope-intercept form, along with a table and its graph. At the bottom, you can also see what point-slope form of this linear function would look like. We will learn about both forms in this unit, focusing primarily on slope-intercept form, but lessons 7 and 8 will introduce you to point-slope form as well. Here's an example of an exponential function written in explicit form. The table and graph of the exponential function are also provided. The focus of the unit is comparing these two types of functions. The essential question driving that comparison will be, what similarities and differences exist among linear and exponential functions? How does the rate of change for a linear function compare to the rate of change of an exponential function? Here is a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit. Some of these vocabulary terms should already be familiar to you from the previous unit or previous courses. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content of this unit. You should be able to find the slope of a linear function from a graph, write functions to model arithmetic and geometric sequences, and solve linear equations. You should be able to use the distributive property to simplify expressions and convert between tables, graphs, explicit equations, and recursive formulas to model real-world situations. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resources website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy this unit.